second year grad student. My area is fibers and textiles. I'm originally from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, so born and raised in Milwaukee. Experiment with what I knew growing up, as well as continuing to even do research about my own background. The legend goes that as Hmong were being pushed out of China, they had to hide their language because they were being forced to learn the dominant language. And so their way of trying to preserve their language was through cross-station bartering. Text and needle and thread has always been something that was really close to me. Like, I always went back to that method of making. This piece is something that's become more personal and less about cultural identity, but more about survivor identity. And what I mean by survivor is the sexual abuse survivor. So this piece was relating to the loss narrative that happens when victims can't come out. At first, I started working with the idea of protection in terms of like apparel and clothing and clothing that protect us. And so as I wrote more about, you know, this concept of protection and what it meant to me, of cultural identity and also how I identify as a survivor, I started realizing that I was making these sort of objects of protection. And so this body of work not only focuses on cultural identity, but my identity as a survivor of sexual abuse or sexual assault. How can I make these objects for people who, when they wear it or when they carry